superstar boxer Frankie Gomez and his trainer Ronnie Rivota. And today we talked about his fight that's coming up this weekend in Vegas.
You're going to be on a big stage in Vegas on the undercard of this major fight. How does that feel?
It feels great. It's like a dream come true. I mean, who doesn't wish they could fight in a pay-per-view if they're a boxer, you know?
You told me he was born ready. What would you say?
I said he wasn't born, he was made. That's Frankenstein Gomez, the monster from East LA. Now I'm Dr. Frankenstein.
Hey, Frankie, what do you say about that nickname, Frankenstein Gomez? He's a badass, though.
Yeah, well, that's the name I wanted to give him, but of course he chose Pitbull. I didn't want to give him Pitbull because that's what they used to call me. You know, all my friends in high school. So.
No offense, you look more like a Pitbull. You don't look like a Pitbull. He looks like a Rottweiler.
Exactly.
How are you feeling right now? Are you ready for your fight?
I'm feeling great. I'm at weight already, so.
You just met a legend right here standing near us. What was that like?
It's been great. I mean, you're a wonderful fighter. I wish I could do all the things he has done.
Break down his fight, him against Diaz.
Well, it's going to be a battle, but I think Mark is going to take it.
But everything's been good with you guys.
Yeah.
Cool. Frankie, how do you deal with the weight loss? Like, deal with the weight, the diet? Is it okay?
I go to his house.
Yeah, he stays at my house. We've been there for 17 days.
What do you eat?
He eats what I tell him to eat. And when I don't tell him to eat, you know, right now he's young. He likes to eat. He just thinks he can do certain things. But I have to teach him, you know, the fundamentals of what to eat and how to eat and when to eat and how many times a day to eat. I'd rather have him eat a lot of small meals. And sometimes he doesn't want to eat.
The fans absolutely love this guy. Did you know this would happen from day one?
You know what? We always talk about a dream, but of course, like with anything in life, nothing comes true unless you go for it. And we used to go for it every day.
It's amazing, though.
I don't know. I'm amazing, too, I guess.
Something you have, huh?
Yeah, something.
Perfect. Thank you very much. You're ready? You're prepared? What's the name of the guy you're fighting?
I don't even know. They keep switching it up.
I will skip that. Anything else you can add about him? What do you think about him as a fighter, about his skills?
Oh, he's a great fighter. I wish I could fight as the good fights he fought, like Pacquiao and stuff. So.
I just noticed this. Someone asked for autograph. You went into the stands. You got them. You had him sign and you gave it back to them. It wasn't even for you. Why do you do that?
Those my friends, my fans, my people.
You just give them back.
Yeah.
Perfect. Thank you. Good luck. I asked Freddie Roach about you, and you know what Freddie told me?
What?
That you beat Jose Benavides in the amateurs, and he said anyone who beats Jose Benavides has to be good. What do you say about that?
Well, yeah, I mean, we fight in the amateurs. That's the amateurs. But it's in the amateurs, stays in the amateurs. This is a pro game, so it's going to be a different thing.
What do you think about Jose Benavides Jr.?
I think he's a pretty good fighter. I mean, I fought him like 3 times. So.
Message to your fans?
My fans keep on supporting me, and I'll keep getting them the best fight I could.
Oh, there you have it, Ronnie Rivota and superstar boxer Frankie Gomez, ready to make things happen. In East LA, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.